Welcome to Highlights of Jazz Music, a series exploring the history of jazz recordings from Joplin to Mahavishnu, from ragtime to fusion, 1916 to 1971. I'm your host, Justin Bouchard. In this eighth episode of Highlights of Jazz Music, we surveyed the end of the jazz age with the recordings of both 1928 and 1929, a two-year period that saw the burgeoning suite style coexist together with the red-hot jazz style. We ended the last episode with the musical partnership of C. Melody saxophonist Frankie Trumbauer and cornetist Bix Beiderbecke. We began this episode at the start of 1928, with both musicians in the orchestra led by bandleader Paul Whiteman. While Trumbauer would stay with Whiteman well into the 1930s, Bix's stay would last a little less than 2 years. One of their classic recordings with Whiteman's orchestra is Lonely Melody. In early 1928, three future big band swing leaders made their recording debuts as leaders, Benny Goodman and the Dorsey Brothers. First, Benny Goodman, who is at this time a member of the orchestra led by drummer Ben Pollock, leads a group of Pollock sidemen, among them future bandleader and trombonist Glenn Miller, on A Jazz Holiday. We will hear from Goodman and Miller with the Pollock band later in this episode. Second, Tommy and Jimmy Dorsey lead a studio orchestra on Mary Ann, with the vocal by studio singer Irving Kaufman. Kaufman, who made his recording debut back in 1914 for Thomas Edison, would have one of the longest recording careers, ending 60 years later in 1974. Thank you.
In the sky seems to wink as we go by. Mary Ann, Mary Ann, all the daisies in the dell seems to know, but they won't tell. Mary Ann, Mary Ann, every little rosebud blooming in the heather seems to whisper, go on, get together. I can't wait until the time when we'll hear the church bells chime. I'll be yours and you'll be mine, Mary Ann.
Several songs from the 1920s capture the spirit of the jazz age in their music and lyrics, among them the Charleston and Ain't She Sweet. However, Let's Misbehave by Irvin Aronson and his Commanders captures the decade-long party on a 78 RPM disc.
Let's misbehave. Let's misbehave.
If you'd be just so sweet and only meet your fate, dear, 'twould be the great event of 1928, dear.
Wa da 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 da, wa da 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 da, wa.
Let's misbehave.
That last song was Chloe, Song of the Swamp, featuring Fats Waller sitting at the pipe organ with the rhythm melodists, a small contingent from the Victor House Band, led by Nat Shilkret. On March 14, 1928, the orchestra led by millionaire bandleader Roger Wolf Kahn had a new member in its ranks, trombonist Jack Teagarden. One of the recordings made on this day, She's a Great, Great Girl, would mark the recording debut of Teagarden. Alongside the trombonist, the violin-guitar duo of Joe Venuti and Eddie Lang also participate. Following this recording, we will hear Eddie Lang alone with piano accompaniment on Add a Little Wiggle.
Thank you.
The members of the Austin High School gang, who had been influenced by the records of the New Orleans Rhythm Kings earlier in the decade, would become among the crop of New York studio musicians, playing on numerous record dates under various pseudonyms. One of these names was the Chicago Rhythm Kings, a studio date led by guitarist Eddie Condon. On I Found a New Baby, drummer and future bandleader Gene Krupa makes his recording debut. Afterwards, we will hear from the Ben Pollock Orchestra with the young Benny Goodman and Glenn Miller, both taking a brief clarinet and trombone solo on Singapore Sorrows.
Thank you. Singapore sorrow, Singapore sorrow, stealing around that night. Singapore sorrow, Singapore sorrow, filling each soul with pride. Out through the gloom, they go round to your room. And while you sleep, they just keep right on crooning. Nothing but sadness, nothing but sadness, why did you go astray? You will find gladness, you will find gladness if you just stay away. That's what I heard in that old Chinatown. Singapore sorrow, Singapore sorrow, following you around.
One of Chicago's premier pianists, Earl Father Hines, was making a name for himself during this time with Louis Armstrong's Hot Five Ensemble. When not participating on one masterpiece after another with Satchmo, Hines found time for side projects. One of these record dates, on May 16, 1928, found him sitting at the piano as part of clarinetist Jimmy Noon's Apex Club Orchestra on Four or Five Times. Noon, like Armstrong, was also a New Orleans native, and had also made his recording debut in 1923, and had also been a member of King Oliver's Creole Jazz Band. After Armstrong moved to New York later in 1928, Earl Hines made a series of piano solo records, among them Glad Rag Doll from 1929. We will hear again from Hines in a future episode. Thank you. last song was Handful of Keys, the first in a series of piano solo recordings Fats Waller waxed in 1929. Little known today, trumpet player Jabbo Smith was, in the 1920s, one of Louis Armstrong's rivals on the instrument. The bulk of his recording output was made in 1929, of which we have selected Take Me to the River. Foreshadowing the early 1930s, we showcase two recording studio groups active throughout the late 1920s. First, the ensemble, the Cotton Pickers, play their version of Bessie Smith's 1923 recording, St. Louis Gal. This group features trombonist Glenn Miller. Then we will hear from prolific studio musician and cornetist Red Nichols, leading his Five Pennies ensemble on Back Home Again in Indiana, which had been made way back in 1917 by the original Dixieland Jazz Band. Featured in this version of the Five Pennies includes both Benny Goodman and Jack Teagarden, who together would join the rank of New York's session musicians. Thank you.
Mommy talking to you.
I hear you talking to me.
Just look what you done.
Ain't you been going around naming my mama?
St. Louis gal.
What do you want?
You're going to have your fun.
Oh, you might be right.
You're going to have a lot of fun.
Always have my fun.
I'm always crying the blues, both night and day.
Mm-hmm.
That is now that you've gone.
And I'm going to stay gone too, sonny.
Mama, you will shake in your shoes, y'all what I say. Some fine morn without any warning.
What's that?
St. Louis gal.
That's me, honey.
I'm gonna manhandle you.
I bet you better take your hands off of me.
You'll find yourself in a jam, just as sure as anything it am.
I bet I jam my fist in your big mouth.
Down in Missouri, there will come a time your life won't be worth a dime.
I ain't got but 20 cents now.
You stole my pal St. Louis gal.
Well, didn't you steal my pocketbook, you switcher?
By 1929, Vic Spiderbeck's health had worsened due to bootleg liquor, and his cornet playing had diminished in quality. On top of that, the hot jazz style he loved to play was falling out of favor with the record-buying public. We feature Vic in two recordings he made as the jazz age was nearing its finish. First, Vic in the company of Frankie Trumbauer's orchestra play on I Like That, and then he takes one more hot solo on China Boy at his next-to-last session with the Paul Whiteman Orchestra.
Thank you.
We end this episode of Highlights of Jazz Music with an all-star recording led by trumpeter Phil Napoleon from the spring of 1929. As part of Napoleon's Emperors, the Dorsey brothers, along with Joe Venuti and Eddie Lang, play on one of 1929's big song hits, Mean to Me, which became a record hit for singer Ruth Etting that year. In the next episode of Highlights of Jazz Music, we once again take another break from our chronological survey and showcase the vocalists of the jazz age. Until then, I am your host, Justin Bouchard.